Over the last decade, several central banks have adopted negative interest rates. This unprecedented policy has been associated with many questions and uncertainty. My name is Güneş Kamber.
And I'm Marco Casiraghi. And today, we look at the evidence of the effects of negative interest rates on financial markets, banks, households, and firms. Starting in 2012, the ECB and the central banks of Denmark, Japan, Sweden, and Switzerland adopted a negative interest rate policy, alongside other unconventional policy measures. This decision raised a lot of questions and had many skeptics.
So why did these countries decide to implement a negative interest rate policy? The main reason was that policy rates were relatively close to zero even before the global financial crisis. As a result, in response to a recession, central banks did not have much policy room before venturing into negative territory.
For countries that had already reduced policy rates to zero after the global financial crisis, negative interest rates offered a solution, one that allowed central banks to rely less intensively on other unconventional tools, mitigating their side effects.
Let's take a look at some of the concerns raised about negative interest rates. Will there be a flight to cash?
Would asset prices and exchange rates respond as intended?
Would policy rates be transmitted to bank loans and deposits?
Would negative interest rates harm bank lending and profitability?
And finally, will they lead to heightened financial stability risks?
To answer each one of these questions, let's look at the evidence we have so far from countries that implemented a negative interest rate policy. Will there be a flight to cash? There is no evidence of a sharp increase in the use of cash. For example, in the euro area, the use of cash has grown over the last two decades, but there is no indication that this increase accelerated after the introduction of negative rates.
Will the asset prices and exchange rates respond as intended? The evidence shows that yields fell across the term structure and stock prices rose. Exchange rates responded as expected, with a significant ease of appreciation pressures.
Would policy rates be transmitted to bank loans and deposits? We have seen lending rates to both households and firms fall, with deposit rates also declining. Overall, there is no clear evidence for negative interest rates changing the transmission from policy to bank rates.
Will negative interest rates harm bank lending and profitability? Banks have generally increased lending, in particular, banks with more liquid assets. Bank profits have not significantly deteriorated, despite lower net interest margins. However, smaller and more specialized banks were adversely affected, and some bank stocks did suffer.
Would negative interest rates lead to heightened financial stability risks? Low interest rates, even positive, already raise significant financial stability concerns. Negative interest rate policies did not compound the problem. Banks, for example, seem to take on more risk following the adoption of negative rates, but the increase doesn't appear excessive. Similarly, other financial institutions did not experience significant disruptions, as many feared.
Overall, most of the potential side effects associated with negative rates have failed to materialize or have turned out to be less relevant than expected. On the contrary, via its impact on financial variables, the reduction of policy rates in negative territory seems to have the intended positive effects on output and inflation.
So, what does our work imply for the future of monetary policy? Because of secular trends, many central banks may be forced to consider negative rates sooner or later. Based on the evidence, we argue that central banks should maintain or include negative rates as part of their toolkit. even if they currently do not expect to use this policy.